Hi! In this tutorial, we are going to make a laser gun using a laser particle. The beginning part of the video is the laser effect video of last time. So if you want to watch the laser gun part, please go to the time link indicated in the comments. First, create a material to be applied to the particle and click it to open a window. Next, set the material's blend mode to translucent. Next, create a text scored node and a component masked node. Check the green channel of the component masked node and connect it to the text scored node. Next, create a subtract node and connect it with the component masked node. Set the value of the subtract node to 0.5. If you preview the subtract node, you can see that the colors are split up and down. Next, hold down M on the keyboard and click to create a multiply node, and connect the subtract node to part A and part B of the multiplying node. When you preview the multiply node, you can see one black line appearing at the center. After creating a 1- node, connect it to the multiply node to invert the color of the multiply node. Next, create a power node and click while holding down the S on the keyboard to create a parameter node. After setting the name and value of the parameter node like the video, connect the 1- node and the parameter node to the power node. Now, if you preview the power node, a horizontal white gradient line appears. To fix the color, create a clamp node and connect it with the power node. Next, create a particle color node and then a multiply node. Connect the alpha channel of particle color and the clamp node to the multiply. Lastly, connect the multiply node to the opacity node and connect the particle color's RGB node to the emissive color node. Save and return to the content browser. Next, create a particle system and click to open a window. Disable the spawn of the emitter list and remove lifetime, initial velocity, and color over life. Next, after setting the type data to the beam data, create the source and target of initial color and beam list. Click required to set the material to the one created in the first place. Click the beam data to set the speed to a value of 2500 or higher. Click the initial size to set distribution to vector constant and set X, Y, Z values like the video. Click Initial Color to set the color you want, then increase the value to make the color shine. Click Source and Target to set the methods as user set, so you can set the values in the blueprint. Then click Target to set distribution to 0 to initialize the target's position value. When finished, save and return to the content browser. Next, create a blueprint in the form of actor and click it to open the window. Click the Add component to add the cube static mesh component. Go to the event graph of the blueprint, create a sequence node, and connect it to the event tick node. Next, create the Do Once node, connect it to the first pin of the sequence node. Next, create the Spawn Emitter Attach node, and connect it with the Do Once node. Set the previously created laser particle to the Spawn Emitter Attach node, drag the cube mesh from the component window, and connect it to the Attach to Component pin. And promote it to a variable by dragging it from the Return Value pin of the Spawn Emitter Attach node. Next, drag the remaining pin of the sequence node to create a set beam source point node and a set beam end point node for the laser particle and connect them together. Go to the particle folder of the start content and copy the spark particle. Change the name of the particle and click to open a window. Click required of spark in the emitter, change the material to laser material, and set the lifetime like the video. Next, click on Spawn to decrease the rate a little, and set the color over life of all emitters except smoke to the color set in the laser material. After saving, return to the content browser. Find the character blueprint and click to open a window. Create a bool variable and name it fire. Then, create two fire variables as a form of set, decide one value to true and the other to false, and connect them to the input action node like the video. Next, click the blueprint created in the form of actor to open a window, copy all the nodes of the event graph, and paste them to the character blueprint. drag the sphere component and make it as a form of get, and generate a get world location node, then connect them to each other. Connect the get world location node to the set beam source point node. Drag the first person camera and make it as a form of get. Then create a get forward vector node and connect them to each other. After creating the vector multiplication node, set the value to 2000 and connect it to the get forward vector node. Next, create a vector addition node, connect nodes to the vector addition node like the video, and connect the vector addition node to the set beam endpoint node. Next, drag the pin of the event tick node to create a branch node. Then get the fire variable as the form of get and link it up with the branch node. After copying the sequence node connected to the existing event tick node, connect two sequence nodes to the branch node like the video, and increase the pin of the sequence nodes to 4 each. Next, create a doOnce node and connect it to the sequence node. After that, create a spawn emitter at location node, set the laser hit particle on the created node, and connect it with the doOnce node. Drag the pin of the spawn emitter at the location node to promote it as a variable and give a name. Remove the variable which was connected to the existing spawn emitter attached node and link the sphere component. Next, create two bool variables and give each of their names laser spawn and laser hit spawn. Next, make the two bool variables a form of set and give them true values. Connect them to particle nodes like the video. Connect two of the pins from the sequence node, which was connected to false of the branch node, with the reset pins of the doOnce nodes, respectively. Next, generate a line trace by channel node and connect it to one of the pins in the sequence. Right after this, Connect the Get World Location node to the start pin of the line trace by channel node, and connect the Vector Addition node with the end pin of the line trace by channel node. Then, check the trace complex. After that, make a branch node and connect it to the line trace node like the video. Next, connect the break hit result node with the line trace node to reflect the result value of hit of the line trace. Make two set visibility nodes and generate a laser hit particle as a form of get. Link them to the set visibility nodes. Connect each set visibility node to the branch node, and check new visibility in the set visibility node, which was connected to the true of branch node. For the next step, create a set world location node by dragging the laser hit particle nodes pin and connect the node to the set visibility node. And then, connect the location pin of break hit result to the set world location node. Next, link the sequence node to the set beam source point node, which was unconnected. Make two branch nodes and link them to the sequence node's rest of pins. And then, create variables of laser spawn and laser hit spawn as a form of get, and connect them to each of branch nodes. Next, make a laser spawn as a form of set and connect it to the branch node. Create laser particle as a form of get and create destroy component node to connect the laser particle node with laser spawn variable. Next, create is valid node and connect it to the branch node, and then connect the laser hit particle, which was created as a form of get with is valid node. After that, draw the pin of laser hit particle to create a deactive node, and connect the deactive node to the is valid node. For the last step, create laser spawn variables as a form of set and connect it to the deactive node. When it is completed, compile and go back to the content browser. Now, play and click. You can see a gun fires laser and hit particles are being created where the laser reaches.